The first step in the inoculation process is to create an environment that will favor the inoculation process. This will require high humidity for a 24 to 48 hour period. We have a portable humidity chamber that is made of PVC pipe and plastic drop cloths. Humidity is provided by a humidifier that will run during the time of the experiment. We isolated two different fungi from the lesions, so we will test both fungi. The fungi are harvested by adding water to the colonies, then gently brushing the colonies to dislodge the fungal spores. You can see how the water is becoming cloudy. The suspension of spores is then transferred to a beaker. The concentration of spores could be determined or modified at this point. When the water was added, it was clear. Now the suspension is turbid from the amount of spores that were harvested. There are two methods that we could use to apply the spores. We could do this using the swab or brush that we use to dislodge the spores from the culture. Or a suspension of the spores could be placed into a sprayer and the plant is sprayed with the spores. We spray the leaves until runoff occurs. The process of adding water is done to the second group of plates that has the dark mycelium. In this case, the water seems to be repelled by the mycelium, and the brushing off of the spores seems more like squeezing air out of the culture. Again, a suspension of spores will be collected. Since the isolations were done from lesions on a basal plant, we have a pot that has three plants. One plant was inoculated with each fungus, leaving one plant as the uninoculated control. Leaves were sprayed until runoff occurred. The plant is then moved to the humid chamber and left for 24 hours. You can see the amount of moisture, call it fog, that the plant was under for that time. This gives the fungal spores enough time to infect the plant. After this time, the plant is removed and the leaves are checked for symptom development during the next few days. Often, symptoms become apparent by the time the plant is removed from the humid chamber. The leaves that were inoculated with the clear spores developed these symptoms that were identical to the original symptoms. The other plants did not show symptoms.